What are you doing?
Just looking for another job. Something I can do as well as the pizzas.
You found anything?
No, not yet. But I will get us out of this mess, you know. I promise. Hey, I was wondering if Owen's got any labouring work going.
That's it.
Well, could you ask him? Put in a good word.
Not really.
Why not?
Well, come on, who's going to give him a job round here?
Cheers.
Well, mate, you were selling drugs from the garage.
I had no choice. Jace, you know I'd never do anything like that unless my back was against the wall.
Yeah, like it is now.
Jace, but he only wants a job.
Look, I'm not going to vouch him. Sorry.
Ignore him.
He's right, though.
Something will come up.
Like what? And who are you going to ask for references? Tyrone and Kevin? We're screwed.
I'll go get another job.
But you love working at the
office. No, something to work around my shifts.
You shouldn't have to work to pay off my debts.
Look, it's our debts, and I don't mind.
I do. It's not fair.
Life isn't, babe. I learned that a long time ago.
Simple. Otherwise, why did he blurt it out in front of everyone?
Because he's under the thumb, isn't he? Literally.
Well, I can't blame Kevin for reacting the way he did.
Oh, don't you start, Reed. I need you on my side. It's bad enough everyone else pointing the finger.
Hey, I'll always be on your side. Always. And if there's anything else I can do to help, you only have to ask.
Well, I don't suppose you've got any shifts going. Oh, what's that?
That is the fourth time that's gone off this morning. Ooh, wait till I get hold of that, Carl. Sorry, love, you were saying?
Have you got any work going?
Oh, I'm afraid not. Unless we can get rid of Norris, if only.
All right, well, thanks anyway.
Hang on. Owen put a card in the window yesterday. Part-time clerical assistant at the yard.
Oh. Experience essential. See, I've never worked in an office before.
Well, it's not rocket science. You'll soon pick it up. And anyway, I'll vouch for you.
Would you?
Of course I would.
OK, I'll go and find him. Thanks, Rita. Hiya.
Hey. Morning.
Ooh, I want a word with you.
You said you'd have it done by this afternoon.
I'm doing you a favour. It's a Sunday.
Yes, but I've got an emergency job on, Kev.
I'll have it done by 5 o'clock, the best I can do.
Owen, I've just seen your card in the cabin window.
No, sorry, love, aren't you? Well, you're not what I'm looking for.
Why not?
Because I want an experienced secretary, not a barmaid.
What?
Hey, those smoke alarms you sold me kept me and Jack up all night. They kept going off.
Are you sure you've installed it properly?
Yes, they did. I want my money back.
Yeah, OK, I'll sort it.
No. Now, please.
All right.
Pint, please.
Only if you hear me out first.
What?
You can have your pint when I finish speaking.
Stella.
Sorry, I'm busy.
Go on, then, make it quick.
You want someone to organise your office, yeah? I'll offer my services on a trial basis, say 3 days, no charge. If you don't like, you get rid. No win, no fee.
Well, 10 out of 10 for originality, holding me a pint hostage.
Well, you know, you did say I was a barmaid. Might as well use my assets.
All right, you're on. Trial basis.
And don't worry, I'll work around my shifts.
You couldn't do tonight, could you, love? Only I got a client coming first thing in the morning. I can't find any of the paperwork.
Well, I suppose I could let you go at 6.
Stella, you rock.
I know.
Strong pints, as you can see. And obviously, I don't expect you to sort it all out tonight, but if you can find any paperwork to do with the Happy Ship Cafe, I'd be very, very grateful, yeah. I've got a few jobs for them. All I can find is this.
OK, and it could be anywhere?
Yeah, it could be. Sorry.
All right, no problem. I'll try my best.
Great. Right, then. I'm off to pick up my van and fix an emergency boiler. Back in a couple of hours.
Bye.
See ya. Am I in the right place?
Well, I've made a start. There's still that pile over there, but I have been through it and it's nothing too urgent. Oh, and here's the Happy Ship Cafe paperwork. There's 2 invoices that still haven't been paid, so you might well let them know when you see them tomorrow.
Ooh, they owe me nearly £1,000. Good work.
So I presume my trial is over. Do I get the job?
You certainly do. Can you start tomorrow?
Yep. That's what I call a welcome home.
I got a job.
As a stripper?
No, as a security man for a warehouse and so
on. Oh, that's great.
Mm-hmm. Oh. So start anyway, at least there'll be a few extra quid coming in.
Yeah, well, I got a new job too, working for Owen.
What, as a builder?
No, idiot. In the office, filing and stuff. 4 days a week before the Rovers.
Oh, when are we going to see you? I mean, I'm going to be delivering pizzas 3 to 8, and then I'll be in the warehouse all night. You'll be gone by the time I get back.
Well, you know what they say. Absence makes the heart grow fonder.
Yeah, well, if my heart got any fonder, it'll explode, then.
You fancy some celebrity drinks?
Not sure I should be going in the Rovers after yesterday.
Do you want Tyrone and Kirsty to beat us? Because I don't.
You're right. We've got nothing to be ashamed of.
Okay. Maybe what I do is top up.
Oh, okay.
Sure she was giving me evils.
She wasn't.
I smiled at her and she didn't smile back.
Well, maybe she's just having a bad day. I've told you that nobody believes what Tommy said.
How do you know?
Because you're a pregnant lady and he's a lying head case. We've proved that.
It'll never happen again, I swear.
I know.
Two bottles, please, Stella. We're celebrating.
Left your boxing gloves at home, I hope.
Yeah, we have.
So Owen gave you the job then?
Yes, 4 mornings a week. Can we work around that, by the way?
I'm sure we can manage.
Tommy's got a new job too.
Something legal, I hope.
Just a security guard for a warehouse.
Please let that be the sound of you choking.
Is that the best you could do?
Says the girl who's patting knickers for a living.
Well, I hope it pays well, because your first instalment's due tomorrow.
Yeah, I know.
Good. Just a reminder.
You know, Ty, you're beginning to sound more and more like your abusive girlfriend by the day.
Can we go? I'm not feeling too good.
Oh.
Yeah, of course.
That's right, Ty. You heal like a good dog.
Oh, sorry, did I wake you up?
No, I woke up about an hour ago. I'm going back to sleep. You look shattered, babe.
Yeah. Charlie says I'll get used to it.
Who's Charlie?
He's the old guy I was working with. Says that he's been doing it 27 years.
And how long did it take him to get used to it?
He didn't say, but he's got no family, 7 cats, 4 dogs, and I feel like I know each one of them personally.
Oh, poor you. Do you want some breakfast?
No, I just want to go to bed.
OK, well, it's still warm for you.
Hey, I've got one bit of good news.
Yeah?
Yeah, that was some extra shifts going next week.
Hey, look, there's a limit, OK? You can't push yourself that hard.
I just want to get this debt paid as soon as possible. That's the most important thing.
Come here.
Ty?
Is it coming?
Is what coming?
Baby.
No, it's not coming.
Does it feel like it might? Any twinges? Anything different?
Just because it's the due date today doesn't mean it turns up on cue.
Why bother giving us a due date in the first place, then? Why not just say, could be first week of September, give or take?
I don't know.
They said Monday, 3rd of September. I'm ready.
Me too. I'm not sure about Junior.
Anyway, I've charged the phones, put the hospital number in, I've packed the bag, and I've planned out 3 separate routes to the hospital, you know, just in case with road works, traffic conditions, time of day, etc.
So, all we need now is a baby?
No, no movement. How about we go and have breakfast in the calf?
Well, I'll leave the house. What if the baby comes?
I am not sitting on the sofa all day waiting.
I've got some DVDs.
Oh, no. Come on, I've read the book. And the book says keep active. Maybe it needs a little jiggle to get things going.
Right, I'll get the phones. And should we take the bag or leave it? Or I could put the bag in the car.
I'll get dressed. All right. Never mind feel. I look like a wee big, fat, wobbling weeble.
You look gorgeous.
Yeah, you have to say that. You made me like this.
You sure you're OK?
I'm fine.
Well, what is it? Can you feel something? Is it coming?
It's so easy to wind up.
But don't do that, my heart's racing now.
That's one of the perks of the job.
Wow, you're enormous.
Hey, Simon, you don't say that to a pregnant woman.
Oh, sorry. No, he's right, I am enormous.
I won't come too close. I'm due to explode today.
You're not going to explode. I know our babies are made.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, all right, we know you do. We don't need the biology lesson, thank you very much. Anyway, your bus is coming. Let's get you to school. Good luck.
Thanks.
I thought I was the one eating for two.
Mm-hmm. I don't know when I'm going to get my next meal. Going into labour for the first time, it can take hours. And we know how bad hospital food
is. Oh, go to work, please, relax.
No, I want to stay with you. I need to be close.
You are close. You've got phones. I can tell you what, I promise to stay within shouting distance of the garage.
No, I'm not going to leave you on your own.
That'll be my last chance to be on my own for 20 years. Go to work, don't take any call-outs, and I'll call you at the first sign of action.
You sure?
I'm positive.
And what are you going to do?
Don't know. Oh, I could go and get this week's instalment from Tommy.
He said he'd bring that round after work.
Yeah, he's not exactly Mr. Reliable.
No, but you need to save your strength. Think of it like you're running a marathon. Conserve your energy, keep hydrated.
And if I get bored?
Then there's DVDs under the telly. I'll see you later.
She's going to pay for it.
Oh, all right, see ya.
Tina.
Hello.
Hi, can I have two coffees and a sticky bun, please, Anna?
Is the bun for you or for Owen?
Owen, I just need coffee and plenty of it.
You've been burning the candle at both ends?
No. You've been working two jobs each to pay off our debts. Can't fall back with the repayments. You know how nasty people get.
Oh, have you two ended up with debt?
It's a long story. It wasn't that long ago we were looking to buy Jason's flat. And now I leave Tommy trying to get a few hours sleep after his night shift before he starts working on his pizza delivery job.
Oh, well, you know, we're all in the same boat. At least you can get away with it at your age. Right, two coffees. Get these lids on.
There you go.
Sticky bun. Tell him we're sold out. It's getting a bit thick round the waist.
OK. There you go. Cheers.
What's going on?
It's payday. Or had you forgotten?
No.
You promised Tyrone you'd pay him back.
Yeah, I said I'd go to the bank later and drop it in.
Oh, well, as long as that suits your busy timetable. Never mind the fact that it's my due date today.
Really?
Yeah. So by the time you get round to paying us today, we could be in hospital giving birth. Great excuse for you to weasel out your responsibilities.
Look, I've just got off a night shift and I've slept for 24 hours.
Well, maybe you should have thought twice before you guilt-tripped Tyrone into lending you money to bail out your feckless dad. I mean, don't worry about us. We're only starting a family here. Only trying to create a bit of stability and security for our new child.
I'll get you the money.
Now?
Yeah, I'll get dressed and go to the bank.
Okay. Bring it to the house. You know where we live.
Oi! What are you doing? Why are you supposed to be in bed?
Gotta go to the bank, get this money for Tyrone.
Well, I thought you were gonna do that later.
I was. Chris came out and woke me up.
Chrissy? The little.
Yeah, well, it's their due date today, so I just want to get all this sorted.
Right, well, I'll sort it. I need to go to the bank for Owen anyway. You get back to bed.
There's not much point now. Start on the pizza soon.
Right, well, at least go home for a rest. You look terrible.
Cheers.
No, I mean it.
I just need coffee. Lots of coffee.
Right, well, you go to the cafe. I'll sort it out, okay? I'll sort Kirsty out.
Hello. Hey, wake up, sleepyhead. You still owe me £2.20.
Sorry.
Hi.
Oh, have you got Tyrone's money?
Yeah, I've just been to the bank.
Right, will you take it round now for us?
No, I'll take it when I'm ready. You okay?
But I fell asleep in there, we'll be late for work.
Oh, right, calm down, Tommy. Look at you, you're exhausted.
But I'm fine, I can handle it.
It's Kirsty's fault. She woke you up on purpose.
Tina, please, don't make this any worse. Please, honestly. Like, just give her the money and everything will go back to normal. It won't even take that long.
You don't owe her a penny.
Please, just promise that you won't make anything any worse.
Right, well, if she starts, I mean it.
I'm serious. Promise.
Promise.
Right, come here. Here's a kiss.
Hey! Put him down. You don't know where he's been.
It's all there.
Just checking.
Oh, you deal with me from now on, okay?
Fine. Let's leave the boys out of it. They're so busy anyway. Well, Tyrone is. Layabout Tommy was still in bed in the middle of the day.
You woke him up on purpose.
I know. Honestly, it's so boring being pregnant. You'd do anything to cheer yourself up.
You're so sick. Tommy's working all hours to pay Tyrone back.
He took advantage.
What? Took advantage?
He gave Terry our money. One day you and your boyfriend are going to have to learn that your actions have consequences.
I think that's a lesson that you're going to have to learn, Kirsty.
I don't need any lessons from you.
I know what you do to Simon.
You know nothing.
Well, I know that you like to knock him about. And he lets you get away with it because he's too decent to fight back. What, do you hit him when you're bored? Give him a quick slap to cheer yourself up?
You sure?
What to you first, does it? Not as much as being beaten with a Hoover tube. Oh, go on, then. You're going to hit me now? Go on, then. Go on. You're going to brain me with a ketchup bottle? Let's see what goes on behind closed doors. Come on.
No rush.
What? You've lost your bottle.
You're very funny. You like picking fights, don't you? But you pick your fights with the wrong people. Remember Rick? I saved you then. I won't do that again. Oh, no. I will get you. One day, in some way, I will hit you so hard your head will spin for a week.
You're all talk.
Really? Not what you were saying earlier. Thanks for this. Same time next week.
Hey, you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I thought you was going to stay inside, keep your feet up.
I need chocolate.
Chocolate?
Yeah, brown stuff, comes in bars.
I know what it, I could get you chocolate.
Yeah, well, I'm up and out now, it's fine.
No twinges?
No.
But it's still moving.
Yes, everything's okay, this is normal, we just have to be patient. I know you're excited, I am too. Won't be long now.
No, okay.
Get back to work.
Get me some.
I might.
See you later.
Hey, you damaged your hinges.
Should wear a wire.
You what?
Kirsty, 9 months pregnant, looks like butter won't melt, yet she just threatened to do me in.
Don't give up.
See? See, nobody believes what she's really like. If you would have heard what she said to me and saw the look in her eyes,
Tina, you need to take a chill pill, all right?
She just tried to attack me with a bottle of ketchup.
Bottle of ketchup? Do you want a boo?
Yes. Yeah, I do, actually. I need to go get changed. I'm in wait less than an hour.
All right, go on then. I'll put the kettle on.
I know it's inappropriate to discuss details, but it does provide a significant boost to our joint disposable income.
Oh, I see.
They don't officially acknowledge it as such, but this performance-related increase does mark me out as a
superhead.
A what?
Superhead.
Oh. Oh, it makes me think he's got superpowers, a flowing cape and a big hammer. Oh. Anyway, we're celebrating his pay rise by looking for somewhere to buy.
Time to get back on the property ladder. Ex-wife took me first house.
Oh, but the Gazette property pages don't come out till Wednesday.
Oh, what kind of place are you looking for?
Oh, I don't know. I mean, we're open to anything.
Somewhere local?
Two bedrooms.
Garden?
Somewhere we can make into a home.
Would you be interested in a flat?
Yeah, maybe.
Well, I might be wrong, but I think your Jason's been looking to sell his place for quite a while. Could pick it up at a reasonable price, especially as your family.
That's right. Jason's flat.
Well, you don't get more local than that.
Hang on a minute. Don't Tina and Tommy live there?
Well, yeah, but I'm sure they could find somewhere else if Jason wanted to sell.
We should look into this. Well, it'd be great for work.
Well, there's no time like the present. Come on.
Thanks for that. Great idea.
You should ask for a finder's fee if they do buy it.
I like to help people get what they deserve.
Yeah, well, they're a nice couple, aren't they?
Yeah.
When are you due, if you don't mind me asking?
Today.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Most people look really worried when I tell them I'm due. Like they're frightened I'm going to go into labour any second.
Not me, no. You know, I once delivered Curly Watt's son in his own living room, practically single-handed. Ooh, the paramedics were most impressed.
Oh, well, I should ask for your number then.
Excuse me?
For when the baby comes. I'm going to be a lot quicker than calling the ambulance.
Well, you see, I'm not actually professionally trained.
Tell you what, I'll get Tyrone to come and fetch you as soon as my waters break.
Well, yeah, I'm still looking to sell, but it seems like it's not a good time for most people.
Well, it's a good time for us. He's just had a pay rise.
Ooh, nice.
Superhead.
You what?
He's a superhead.
All right, what does that mean? You wear your pants over your tights and a cape and that?
See? It's really nice. Oh. Oh, I feel a connection. As important as that, a connection.
Yeah, well, it's a solid place, and it's well appointed.
Oh, hi. I thought I could hear voices.
Hi. Jason's just showing us round.
Oh, that's nice of him.
We're potential purchasers.
thinking of buying a flat.
All right. Since when?
Just found out about it now, actually.
Is it still in the estate agents?
Kirsty told us about it in the cabin.
Kirsty?
Yeah. Does she look set to pop or what? And, seeing as we're family, I was hoping that maybe we could, do a deal.
Well, you can start by making me an offer.
Oh, I can see he's going to be a tough negotiator.
If we did buy it, it wouldn't cause you a problem, would it?
Oh, no, we'd move out somewhere else. It's not a problem.
Oh. Could we see the bedrooms, please?
Yeah, walk this way.
Hiya, only me.
That is what I like to see. Pregnant woman taking it easy. No movement.
Not yet. Present for you on the table.
What's this?
Tommy's payment.
I said I'd sort that.
I'm a multitasker. What do you fancy for tea?
No, you don't have to cook tea.
I wasn't going to. Dial up a takeaway.
Yes. Love the sound of that.
Right, leave it with me. Everything can be sorted without me having to leave the sofa. Why don't you have a bath?
I had a shower this morning.
And what if you have to go to hospital?
Yeah, good thinking. Best be clean. I'll have a good scrub.
You do that.
Mm. And hurry up. We're busting to see you.
What are we having?
Pizza. Of all the pizza joints in all of Manchester.
It's a small world.
You look dog tired.
Been a long day.
You've got a night shift later.
Yep, and you know why?
Well, I'm impressed. How much do I owe you?
15 quid exactly.
Oh, hold on a minute. Those black olives?
No, just deliver them.
I specifically said no black olives. I can't eat that, I'll be sick.
Just pick them off.
Pick them off? You bring me the wrong piece when you tell me to pick them off. I want the pizza that I ordered.
So come on, but don't mess me about.
Take it back and bring me the right order.
You can't be serious.
Unless you want me to call the shop and tell them how rude and incompetent you were.
Look, this is my last delivery. I've got to get off to my security job.
You carry on like this and I'll make sure you have no jobs. Feed my lips. Bring me the pizza that I ordered.
Do it. Oh, there you go, love. I've got on the house. I'm sorry.
What is going on?
Oh, no. What's she done now? Let me think. Apart from waking Tommy up when he needed rest or pushing Jason to sell his flat so he'd be homeless.
Listen, love, you need to move on.
How can I move on when all I want to do is go around there and smash your smug face in?
For your own sanity and for mine, go and take a break and try and calm down.
What can I get you?
Have you seen Carl?
Why, have you lost him?
No. His phone's run out of charge.
Oh, right, yeah, that used to happen a lot. Especially when he was gambling and drinking.
So you've not seen him?
No, I have seen him.
In here?
In the bistro. Why, have you had a row?
No. We're fine. Thanks.
Where's tea?
Pizza place got the order wrong. We've gone back to get it sorted.
Oh, I'm starving.
Me too. You got to trust these people.
Did they say how long?
Nope.
Any more twinges?
No.
I was really hoping it was going to be today.
Me too.
3rd of September, 2012. Just sounds like a good birthday, doesn't it?
Nah, you never know. Might still be time.
Oh, can I have some chocolate then?
I've eaten it all.
Really?
Oh, what's this? Extra rations?
Nah, I love you.
In that case, I'll share it with you.
Share it? That's mine.
I don't think so.
Yeah,
no, I need you.
You're
a pregnant lady. I need chocolate.
You,
oh, hang on.
What? What is this here?
Sucker!
Got to stop doing that.
give this mine.
Yeah. What are you doing?
Can I ask you the same thing?
I'm delivering pizzas. She sent the last one back.
She did what?
Right, it's done now.
Do you know what else she's gonna have done?
What?
Ollie found a buyer for Jason's flat.
Okay.
Right, which makes us homeless.
Oh.
Yeah. And she threatened me. Said, she was gonna get me.
Look, T, we've gotta get past this. Did you give her the money?
Yes. And she got a pound of flesh worth, I tell you that.
Okay, well, it won't be for much longer.
Fire voices. What's going on?
Who is it?
Got your pizza.
All right, thanks.
Sorry about the mistake.
How much do I owe you?
Oh, nothing. It was our fault, so it's on the house.
Right. Bye, then.
Bye.
Night-night.
We'll get through this. She's gonna have a baby any second.
Shouldn't you be at your security job?
Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to take the van.
The pizza van? Do you want to get in trouble?
It's fine. I'll drop it off first thing in the morning. Won't even know it's gone. Oh, come here. We can find a new place to live. Just me and you. Think about that, eh?
Mm.
And she can huff and puff. She'll never have what we have. Back to work.
Hi.
Bye.
I am soulful.
Mm.
A bit like you.
You don't give in, do you? I don't think this baby's coming today.
Right, okay. But I'm still not drinking, just in case I have to take you in during the night.
It won't be long.
You scared?
What?
What's going to happen? Having a baby?
A bit, yeah.
Squeeze my arm. Go on, as hard as you can.
Okay.
Right, okay. We'll be fine. When the time comes, just go for it.
Do you know what? I'd be a lot more scared if I didn't have you.
Yeah?
Best man in the world.
Come here.
Mm. You seem in a slightly better mood now.
Yeah. But I'm sorry for going off on one. And you're right. I do need to protect my sanity.
We all do. However much other people try and mess with our minds.
Yeah.
And violence is never the answer.
Well, that depends on the question. Well, I just need to remember that I've got a great bloke in Tommy.
You make a lovely couple.
Yeah, I've got a good one. And there's nothing Kirsty can do to hurt us.
Hmm. Oh. What's happened?
He's awake.
You've been involved in an accident.
Oh, no way.
Can you remember your name?
Is it Tommy? It's Tommy.
Tommy what?
Duckworth.
I'm going to get you out of here, all right, Tommy? Now try to relax and don't move. There's an ambulance on its way.
My boss is going to kill me.
Don't tell me he'd been in an accident. I just didn't know what to think. I just came here as quick as I could.
Mark, it's okay. Look, Tommy's broken his ankle, and we need to give him an operation to put it right. It's a bit shaken, and we're giving him some drugs for the pain, so he might be a bit drowsy.
When do you need to take him for the operation? Can I go and see him?
Well, someone will be along for him shortly, but you can say hello.
Yeah.
Sure, I'll be pleased to see you. What's been going on about you for the last hour? You have a visitor.
Hey. Hey.
I'll leave you guys to it.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks.
It's typical, isn't it? I've just seen a really nice pair of rollerblades on eBay.
This isn't funny, Tommy. When the hospital rang me, I didn't know what to think.
Okay, I'm fine.
You are not flipping fine. You're just about to go for an operation.
Tina, I need you to calm down, all right?
Tell me how it happened.
Crashed the van.
Oh, God.
I must have just fell asleep at the wheel.
I'm not surprised.
Hey, I don't need it. I told you so's now.
You could have been killed.
Yeah, but I wasn't. Look, apart from my ankle, I came out with barely a scratch.
That's not the point.
You shouldn't have took the van last night. You shouldn't have been driving. You're knackered. You haven't slept. I should have stopped you. I should have hidden your keys and locked you in the house.
No, I'm starting to wish they hadn't called you.
I'm sorry. I can't lose you as well.
Never. Okay, look, that's never gonna happen.
Okay, Tommy, we're ready for you now.
Sure.
Okay, I'll be here when you wake up, okay?
Nice one.
Thanks,
Anna. Oh, I ordered extra toast.
Yeah, it's on its way. Are you still to get a healthy appetite?
Yeah, well, it's the only thing about me that is healthy.
Oh, you're still feeling grotty.
Yeah, I just want it over with now.
You know, I was the same with that, Gary. Set towards the end, my bum was so big I couldn't eat anything that resembled a baby whale.
Yeah, well, according to Tyrone, I'm visible from space.
Alrighty.
Goodness, everyone's an early bird this morning. What can I get you, Lloyd?
Coffee and a gut buster, please. Just the man. Look, I don't know what the deal is with you and Tommy. I thought you might want to know he's in the hospital.
Oh, no.
He had a car accident last night. Thought you'd be interested.
Oh, right. Oh, there you go. Just get your toast.
We'll tuck in.
Man, if I join you.
Start saying I'm chooksed.
It was an accident, babe. Okay, you're exhausted. Hey, at least you still got your looks.
Did the doctor tell him it'd be before I could drive again?
No, he didn't. He did say you're going to be on crutches for about 2 months.
2 months? Oh, that's just perfect.
Hey, don't worry about it. You just concentrate on getting better.
Hiya.
All right.
Thought I'd pop to the shop. Any idea what you fancy for tea?
I'm not really fussed.
That doesn't really help.
Yeah.
What's up?
Nothing. I won't be a sec.
Have you heard anything from the hospital?
I spoke to Tina this morning.
So how's Tommy getting on?
I didn't think you cared anymore.
Come on, Rita.
A broken ankle, a few cuts and bruises. You should go and see him.
I don't think that's such a good idea.
Is that you talking, or Kirsty? Oh, I wash my hands. The pair of you have less sense than a rocking horse.
Well?
Tommy's got a broken ankle. Nothing major.
There's nothing to be concerned about.
No,
guess not.
Got to hear it.
Hiya.
Cheers. Hey, you ought to get going soon.
I'm fine.
Could be kicking you out.
They can try.
Seriously, I don't mind being on my own.
What? So you can beat yourself up? We bounce back, babe. That's what we do. Right. I'll leave my phone on charge, okay? So if you need to talk to me, give me a ring.
You can read me a story.
See? It's nice to see you smile. Can we help you?
It's him I've come to see.
You right, Mickey?
Who's this?
I'm his employer. Or should I say, former employer.
Just what?
You're no use to me like that. And you wrote the flipping van off.
Oh, stuff your van. It's fortunate to be alive.
Tina, please. I was knackered. I made a mistake.
He's working two jobs.
Well, he's got one less to worry about now.
I'm sorry, mate.
Sorry doesn't cut it. Look, I've squared it with the police, but you owe me £2,000 for a new motor.
I don't think so.
Well, I'll tell the police he stole it then.
No, I'm skint, Mickey.
Tough. I'm running a business, not a charity. You'll be hearing from me.
Work all day?
Yeah, pretty much. Got a backlog to clear.
Oh, poor you. On a Sunday.
All extra money for the baby, though. Mm. Any more twinges?
Not since you asked me 10 minutes ago.
When's it gonna come?
I'm sure if you were called out on an emergency, it'd stir itself. Especially if you had no signal, I couldn't get hold of you.
No, that is not gonna happen. This time I'm staying put until it's done and dusted.
If only it knew what a great dad was out here waiting for it. I'd book its ideas up.
Oh, do you mean that?
Of course. You're special.
Cracking breath.
Oh, look, there's Tina and Tommy back from the hospital. Let's go and check, see how he is.
Has somebody got these?
Yeah.
Here
okay.
We are.
Do you want to? No, you're all right. Now put it under this arm.
And it's in there.
Now we are.
Yeah.
Now then, take care.
Cheers.
That's it.
Hiya, Tommy, how are you?
Yeah, I'll live.
Oh, right, everybody. This is my mother, Gloria. This is Rita, Tina, Tommy, Dennis, Kevin and Tyrone.
Nice to meet you all.
We have met.
Oh, yes, how are you? Ooh, another busy top. You'd have to tell me how you get away with it.
I was wondering, Stella, would it be all right if I took tonight off with it being Tommy's first night back?
Well, you'd be lucky. You had yesterday off.
Well, I'm a bit short-staffed, but if you're really after, then I'll...
Oh, no, it's fine. I'll be there.
Thanks, love.
Right, can you walk?
He'll be up and down ladders by Monday week, cleaning windows.
Dennis, may see you in the pub later.
Come on! You forgot your snap tin.
Oh, right,
Hello. Hey, Kuskan, what make is it?
Tina, come on, just let's get you inside. Come on.
We wouldn't be feeling sorry for him, would we?
No?
Yeah.
OK. Now, where's Bess?
Oh, the sofa.
Oh, right, OK. Come on, I'll take those for you,
shall I? Yeah, thank you.
Thanks. All right, get yourself down. Oh. All right, good? OK?
Yeah.
I'll move the telly around, shall I?
Yes, please.
Tina,
Quick
word. Look, I know there's bad blood between you and Kirsty.
She was gloating at me out there.
Whether she was or not, you and Tommy are in enough trouble, you don't want any more.
I know.
Tina, whoever's right or wrong, you'll only make it worse looking for arguments. So, turn the other cheek, eh?
Yeah.
Promise?
Yes, promise.
Right. Well, I better get back to the shop. Are we ready, Dennis?
Yeah, I think so. Right.
And remember, anything else you need... You know where we are.
Thanks, Rita.
Yeah, thanks for everything, Rita.
We'll see ourselves out.
Cheers.
Bye. 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 What would we do without her, eh?
I thought I'd been so stupid we wouldn't need her in the first place.
That's enough of that talk, thank you.
Look, seriously, if you've had enough, I don't mind.
Shut it. Look, I love you. I'm not going anywhere. Just get used to it. Happy birthday.
I almost forgot.
See? It's not all that bad, is it? What are you, Jace?
Hiya. How's your leg, pal?
Yeah, not bad. You can be the first person to sign my cast if you want.
T, get me a pen off there.
Listen, Jace, I'm not going to be away, am I? Just parked up here for a couple of months.
Yeah, look, I've been speaking to Brian and Julie.
About the flat?
It's not good news, I'm afraid. They've made me an offer and I've accepted.
So, what?
Well, they want to move fast and you paid the rent till the end of the month. You have to be out by then. Look, I am really sorry, guys.
Where are we going to go?
I know it's short notice.
Yeah, you can say that again.
But I have been trying to sell this place for the last 2 years.
It's broken his ankle, if you have noticed, Jason.
Yeah, and they're going to make me pay for that pizza van.
Yeah, but am I going to get this chance again? You know, it might be another 2 years till I find a buyer. And prices are dropping every month.
Oh, so what, you're just going to chuck us out on the street then?
Don't make this any harder for me.
Harder for you?
Look, I am sorry. Honest to God, but I'm left with no option.
It's been on the cards for a while.
Yeah. Can see you coming this soon, though.
Yeah, but you can't blame Jason.
Yeah, I know.
He's got to do what he's got to do.
It's all my fault, this. I've got into this mess.
Kirsty's, you mean? I've got a right mind to go around and kill her now.
Yeah, a lot of good that'd do.
Right, well, I better get back to work. I just don't like leaving you, though.
Yeah, well, I feel bad just sat here doing nothing while you earn all the money.
Tommy. What are we going to do? Hey, bottle.
Hey, Tina.
Yeah?
What number Inkerman Street is that you missed that job on? Do you remember?
Inkerman Street.
Sorry to bother you on a weekend.
Oh, no, it's all right. 14, I think.
Right, well, when you're back tomorrow, can you give the scaffolds a ring?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, thanks. Hey, how's Tommy getting on?
He's bearing up.
Only Jason saw me, he sold the flat. What are you going to do?
Good question.
Well, something will turn up, yeah?
Do you know Tommy has to pay for this van that he wrote off?
I didn't know that. What's he going to do if he can't work?
No idea.
Oh, sweetheart.
What are we? It's endowing and it's keeping getting worse and worse.
I'm sorry, look. Listen, if I wasn't feeling the pinch myself, I'd help you know that, don't you?
Yeah, it's all right. I'm sorry to dump this on you.
No, it's all right.
And I can give you time off if it helps.
Thanks, but we need all the money we can get.
Well, how long's Tommy off for?
A few months. But like you said, something will turn up.
Well, let me know how it goes, okay?
Yeah.
Listen, I'm sorry I can't help more.
It's only Sunday. Feels like I've been here 2 weeks already.
Doesn't it just? Sorry I'm late. I have to organise Tommy.
Oh, that's all right, love. I'm just going to dump my stuff.
Plenty others would like your job, you know. Tina, is it?
Mother.
Well, no one's ever late for me in my bar in Spain, because they know what they'd get.
Oh, just ignore Tina. Can we just get one thing straight? This is my pub, and I'll run it my way, all right? I'll leave my stuff alone.
It's your funeral.
So have you told Tommy and Tina?
Yep.
Oh, are they okay about leaving?
Well, it's going to be a little bit tricky, what with his ankle and that.
We can't hang about, you know.
Oh, no, it'll be no problem, it'll be okay.
But where are you going to live then?
Well, I'm not sure yet, am I?
Hey, Julie, it's no excuse now, is there, for being late for work, living next door?
Every silver lining has a cloud.
They say you got to rest up when you've broken your ankle.
Well, he hasn't got much choice, has he? He's only going to run a 4-minute mile. Have you thought what you're going to do about his toilet needs?
You what?
Well, he's going to need to have a big jam jar handy, isn't he? I mean, think about it. All that struggling on his crutches to the bathroom, then standing over the bowl.
Yes, Mother. I think we get the picture now.
Oh, I hope she doesn't start upsetting Tina.
Oh, I don't think so. I had a firm word with her this morning on that very subject.
Orange juice, please. You still doing food?
Only sandwiches now.
Might have another pizza later in that case. And again, maybe not.
£1.20.
Do you want?
Can I come in?
Look, we're paying you back as fast as we can.
It's not about that. I just want to talk.
How are you feeling?
You heard Jason selling up?
Yeah.
Yeah, so if you come with any more bad news...
I haven't. I just wanted to say, about the money, I still want it back. But there's no rush.
Does Erin Dawes know you're here?
It's got nothing to do with Kirsty.
Yeah, well, she pulls the strings on every move you make.
I haven't come here for a row. I'm trying to make things easier for you.
Look, I don't get it. Why?
Because you're Jack and Vera's flesh and blood. And when all said and done, you're a mate. I don't want this big rift between us.
Yeah, well, I appreciate that. But it doesn't stop me worrying about you and Kirsty and what's she doing to you. Oh,
look, will you just leave that? I'm sorting that. It's just to put me and you back in the frame. Deal?
Deal.
There you are. What was your name again? I didn't quite catch it this morning.
Dennis.
Dennis the Menace. Right, I'll have to watch you.
They're lovely, aren't they? Names that rhyme.
Yes.
I'm his wife, Rita. Nobody's sweeter. Unless someone starts to get right up my nose.
Bad news about Jason selling the flat. But I told you I'd get you.
Right, you evil little cow!
What?
Tommy has lost his job because of you.
Me?
He's broken his ankle and we've been evicted because of you.
What are you talking about?
I can stand there and go.
Oh, I'm out of here.
No, I'm not finished with you.
Get off.
Tina.
I'm going to show everyone what you're like.
I haven't a clue what she's
talking
about.
You threatened to get me back.
Is she making a threat,
sir? We're not going to get away with this.
Oh, no, you don't.
Oh, go on, Milky, go on. I hardly touched you.
You're right.
My waters are broken. Oh. This baby's coming.
Call an ambulance.
Slowly does it.
Oh, my back.
All right, do you think you can walk just through to there?
You're going to be fine. Just take one step at a time.
Ambulance is on its way.
So is this baby. Oh. All right, deep breaths, you're going to be fine.
Don't worry, Marcus knows what he's doing.
He's not the only one, love. Now, come on, bring her through to the lounge.
He's a practicing midwife.
Oh, now we're going to keep an eye on her BP. Where's a girl when you need one?
Right, we're nearly there, OK?
Sure, we need plenty of towels, hot water. Oh, are you going to manage in here without assaulting anyone else?
I didn't... Yes, I'll be fine.
Has someone found Tyrone?
Yeah, I'm on it. Oh, good luck, Kirsty. And you? We're all disgusted with you, madam.
It was a little push. I didn't know her waters were going to break.
Are you for real? She's 9 months pregnant.
Bravo, my love. Best leave it at that. Unless she tries to kick your head in.
Don't you dare go after her.
I wasn't going to.
Kev said you fell asleep at the wheel.
Yeah, I've been getting my beauty sleep. It was all thanks to Kirst. Yeah, but look, at least he didn't run anyone over.
Oh, he just wrote a van off.
Yeah, which I owe him £2,000 to replace.
Ouch.
But at least me and you are talking. That's something, I suppose.
Yeah. Jack and Vera would be chuffed.
Oh, how's Kirsty? Supposed to be overdue by now.
We're on pins. Can't wait to hold it in my arms.
It's a lucky kid. Having a dad like you.
Well, cheers. And it'll be the making of Kirsty, I'm telling you.
I hope so, mate.
I'm telling you.
Blimey, this baby isn't hanging about. I can see the head. Right, Kirsty, I need you to give me a really big push now. You're doing brilliantly.
Oh, excellent dilation. Oh,
Mother, get back up this end.
I need... Oh, Tyrone!
Maria's gone to look for him. He'll be here soon, don't worry.
He's been like a limpet for days. And just when you need him most. Oh, no way.
That's it, you're a natural.
36 hours in agony having her. This baby's flying out.
How's your back holding up?
Can't tell. Everything hurts.
Oh, is Maria, look.
Tired.
No, I'm sorry. The garage is all locked up and he's not at home. I've been to the cafe and I've left him a voicemail, so...
Oh, I need him.
I'm sure he'll be here soon enough.
They're more trouble than they're worth. You'll be dog-tired, sore up there, sore down there, and he'll be out getting trolleyed with his mates, wetting the baby's head.
No! Kirsty, I need you to give me a really big push after three, OK? You ready? One, two, three.
Why don't they... Tell you how much he cares!
The woman's out here, out here. And you knocked her over.
Oh. You're right.
Oh, I'm such a wuss, I can't stand the sight of blood.
How is she?
Marco's got it covered. Mum's got the box set of ER, I think she's an expert.
How's Kirsty's back?
I don't know. The main priority is to get this baby out safely. Where is this flipping ambulance?
Stella, I don't mean...
Not now, Tina, not now.
Ty! Oh, Ty, where have you been?
Oh, thank goodness for that.
Why, what's up? Is it Kirsty?
Yeah, she's in labour. To the back.
What? In proper labour? Left my phone in the flaming car.
She's all right. Marcus is with her.
Oh. Here's Daddy.
Just squeeze and break my fingers if you need to.
No, she's doing brilliant. She's got great stamina. Kirsty, one more push and I reckon we'll see the head, OK?
Roger that, yeah. Keep an eye on her vitals.
I'm fine here, Gloria. Maybe Kirsty with like an ice pack on her forehead or something.
We're all scrubbed in now. 4 hours are better than two. Now, we're going to have to be very careful with that fontanelle.
Why, is there something wrong?
I could do the ice pack.
Look at that little bitch out!
Hey, this is supposed to be a happy time, babe.
Promise me! Promise me you'll keep that lunatic away from me now, baby!
All right, I promise, I promise. What's a miracle?
Each and every one.
Don't look right.
Gloria, will you go and hold Kirsty's other hand or something? I'm a midwife.
I'm a mother.
No offence, but can you do what Marcus says, please? Kirsty's suffering here.
Right, Kirsty. One more great big push and then I think we're in business, OK? One, two... First the shoulders, one... Two, and the rest is plain sailing.
Oh. Well done. Okay. Well done.
Fingers and toes all present and correct.
Cavalry's here. Oh, Kirsty.
A baby girl delivered at 1910. This is Kirsty, a.k.a. Super Mum. Mm. It's her first baby.
Oh, she is gorgeous.
She's perfect. And you look so beautiful.
You're such a liar. Keep an eye on that blood pressure, love.
The placenta's undelivered, obviously, and Kirsty sustained a back injury just prior to her waters breaking.
How?
Courtesy of my barmaid, I'm afraid.
But your barmaid.
But Tina.
Who else?
Right, let's get you into the ambulance and we'll let the docs have a good look at you. We'll check out your back as well.
Okay.
careful with her.
Oh, I'm sure they know what they're doing with her.
That's your flannelette sheet done for a bird.
Hey, you take care. She's beautiful.
Thank you.
Oh, she's gorgeous.
I still can't believe she's here. Where's Marcus?
Hey, you did great.
Can't thank you enough.
No, you just did.
Here you go. Be careful with Kirsty's back, won't you?
Hi, look, I swear I didn't...
Hey, if you wasn't a girl, I'd knock you into next week. And if you've done anything to hurt Kirsty or that baby, if they find anything wrong because you shoved her, my whole life is on that ambulance.
We know, love. You should get back behind that bar.
Rita, you know that I didn't mean to hurt her.
Whatever you mean and whatever you do are two totally different things, Tina. And I'm sick to my back teeth of trying to guide you. It's in one ear and out the other. And I just hope there's no lasting damage done to Kirsty and that baby. Not for your sake, for theirs.
This is what we like to see, mother and baby doing well.
So no back problems for Kirsty then?
You've sustained some bruising to the spine, but it's no more than that and shouldn't have any lasting effect.
Oh, that's brilliant news.
And everything else okay?
Apart from being born in a pub.
I believe our Marcus did the honours?
Absolutely. Free MOTs for life.
He's a mechanic.
Ah, right. All right, Mum, we'll keep you and baby in overnight. I'd like you to see a physiotherapist in the morning just to double-check that your back injury won't give you any mobility problems over the next few days.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's great, Doctor. And thank you for everything.
Enjoy fatherhood, especially the first 10, 11 years. Teenagers are a complete nightmare.
All the towels are in the wheelie bin.
Right. And is it all ship-shaped and Bristol fashion back there?
Clean and tidy, if that's what you're on about, yeah.
Good.
Can I have a word, Tina?
Do you want to go to the
toilet? What?
I reckon you're going to be next.
What, giving birth?
Oh, little bundles of Grimshaw joy.
Marcus.
What, don't you want more kids?
Well, yeah, I suppose I'd like Liam to have a little brother or sister, but...
Oh, you and Jason make lovely little bambinos.
Do you reckon? He wants to move in.
Oh, he didn't let the grass grow.
Mm. Been dropping massive hints. You know, sort of as a sledgehammer.
Mm. Can't afford to buy his own place now he's got buyers.
Why, do you think it's too soon?
No, not necessarily.
Right, so you wouldn't mind if I told him that he could move in?
As long as he treats you right. Else I might have to break his legs.
No, I really do like him. And I fancy him like mad.
He's a good lad. Uncomplicated.
Nothing would persuade me that it's right to shove a pregnant woman.
Thanks, Mother. I am handling this.
Zip it, Gloria. Just delivered a baby, but keep it zipped.
You don't know what she was saying. She was...
She is not on the payroll. You are. And that could easily change. Any more flare-ups like that, Tina?
Yeah, I know. Sorry.
Right. Clean slate. Year zero. I spy with my little eye two tables full of empties.
Hello, Angel. I've got loads to tell you. You're going to go to Bessie Street Infants. I'll be there first thing in the morning to put your name down. Baby Dobbs. Because it'll be 2016 before you know it. When I was at school, I was the kid with the dirty neck who whiffed a bit. Not you. You can have a clean uniform every day. Ribbons in your hair. And if you don't play Mary in that nativity, Brian Packham is going to get a potato up his exhaust pipe. He's so beautiful. But no boy is going to look at you until you are at least 35. Maybe 21 will play it by ear. You're daddy's little girl. And daddy's going to take you to the swings. And he'll tuck you in every night. read you a story. Because, you see, I never had any of that. But that doesn't matter now I've got you. It's like you've mended everything.
You pushed her?
Yes, okay, a shove. And it wasn't much of a shove, but she milked it as per. Look,
even Kirsty can't fake her waters breaking.
She was gloating about your accident, us being homeless. I saw red. I wanted her head on a spike. She knows exactly how to wind me up.
Is the baby okay?
Apart from having that monster as a mother, fine.
Is there anything you're not telling me?
No, Tommy, that's your party piece.
I'm just asking, flaming out. I've got a right to ask.
She might have hurt her back.
What, giving birth?
No, when I pushed her, she... She fell backwards into a table.
Great. So she'll probably sue us then?
Yeah, she probably will. But you know, we could add that to the money we owe Tyrone. Go and see a loan shark.
We didn't cop for the greatest dads, did we?
Don't you ever compare my dad to yours!
Just saying. Some kids inherit, I don't know, a semi or a few grand.
My dad loved me! He had a good heart!
Yeah, and did he have a short fuse? Because your temper is out of control when it comes to Kirsty.
She was the reason why you crashed your van.
Maybe I'd have crushed it anyway.
She told Juliet and Brian about the flat being up for sale.
You would have found out anyway.
She was laughing at us. I thought I'd been out on the street.
So? Why don't you just ignore her?
Oh, she'd love this, wouldn't she? You and me being at each other's throats. It's all Christmases.
This stunt you've pulled, I mean, me and Ty were back on track. I had my mate back, my brother.
Unless she was ever going to let that happen to me.
There you go again, you're obsessed.
And it wasn't a stunt, I was defending us.
What, by making everything 10 times worse? I'm here trying to patch things up and you just come in like some mad wrecking ball.
I was trying... What's the point? This relationship's screwed.